So today we are comparing the Volkl Code and the Atomic Redster double deck. The Volkl Code here has a wood core. It's positioned somewhere between a slalom and a GS ski, so it's a little bit wider at the top than you'd be used to, but this gives it kind of more an all-mountain capability. It's aimed at advanced skiers because it's still pretty stiff. A really great fun ski.
I tested the Volkl Code ski. It's really good, really grips well on the firm snow, which is the conditions we've got at the moment. Rating it on long turns, I'd say it was a 4, 4.5 out of 5, really grips well, holds a turn. Short turns, again, I'd say 4, 4.5 out of 5. Unlike the Race Tiger, it's quite springy, it's got a soft tail. You can get a lot of movement out of it, so it's quite playful. 3.5, 4. There's not many moguls, so I didn't give a chance to take it in the moguls, but it's really stable, super stable ski. In fact, I'm going to buy some. Great ski.
Here we have the double deck. This is a more of a GS ski. It's a little stiffer than the Code. Narrow, has a longer radius, but a super fun, playful ski. It's got a beech wood core and a slight 5% race rocker. Great fun for long turns.
Today I've tested the Atomic Redster double deck ski. It's a GS ski. It's quite stiff, quite heavy, but when it's firm and icy, it holds really well, holds a good edge. Short turns, you've got to really work the ski, but it's surprisingly light and easy to rotate. Marks out 5. I think in a long term, I'd give it 5 out of 5 because it's a GS ski and it's really stable. Short turns, it's a GS ski, so it's hard to get a good short turn going, so it's 3.5, 4. Playfulness, it's stiff in the tail, so depends how light you are on your feet, but it can be playful. I'd give it a 3. And then again, stability, it's really stable. It's a GS ski. I was really impressed, and I definitely think about buying a pair.